For studio classes, I'm just going through the basics of this Dunis Daily Dozen first exercise. It's a silent exercise. I think I made a long video, so probably it's been too long for anybody to actually watch it. But starts from this position where all fingers are on different strings, and there is the major six, or like if they were on the same string, there would be major seconds, right? So, and then I do this in this position for now. And I also do this in a little bit of a higher position and not in first position. So because I absolutely don't want to strain my hand by doing something crazy. So I mean, it's also not so important. I think that it's completely in tune, but that should be about that, about right. And yeah, so my weakest finger, if all the others are down, is the third. So I start by lifting. That one. And it still looks quite pathetic, but it's getting better. So the idea is to lift it from here, from the back of the hand or the arm actually, and then to lift it quickly and let it fall. Yeah, Daniel gave me the analogy of a mallet, so it's not hitting into the string, but just with some kind of buoyancy. Also, the string doesn't have to be completely pressed down. So that's the idea. So I can do 1, 2, 3, 4. So I also watch my thumb that it is loose, and my overall head neck coordination, that I'm not kind of tightening up here. So, and then I do the changes with all the other fingers. Always the third finger should be involved. I notice when I do that quickly. Then three and one. Then one can also lift two and leave two down. So I think the most challenging combination is 1, 3 and 2, 4. That was not completely right, so. So that feels a little bit like patting the head and rubbing the belly at the same time. But it can be done. And then I'm also turning this into a trill exercise by doing the trill rhythms like for example for the third finger. That's the one that I already did before, but then also tongue. And then so counting the uplifts, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These are challenging if I can't bow. Yeah, so that's what I'm doing, and I don't know if you have any ideas or if you notice anything that I maybe should work on. I mean, the idea is to train the precision, dexterity, and independence of the fingers. Of course, and also fingers and bows, but for now, just independence of the fingers from each other. And I think, I mean, to do that in position, that requires to find a good hand position first, because I don't want the wrist to be extended, obviously, and if I do it like this, then there is some blockage here for the first finger, so maybe it needs to come around a little bit higher, something like this. So and here, when I do it like this, I notice that I'm not that free in my head and neck as I was before, and also that I noticed it right the first time I did it, that I have some kind of sympathetic reactions in other fingers or in my legs or toes or wherever. So this, I think that looks good, but I feel like I don't have, that my first finger is a little bit like hindered by the neck of the violin. Okay, so these are my ideas. Thank you for watching, and talk to you soon. Bye for now.